My definition of intelligence basically is that it's a tool that we as people are using for achieving some goals. The goals can be, or it can be any kind of goals. But what is the intelligence? When I think about it, I think about it as a tool that represents the real world, which is very complex, into a simplified, some kind of abstract model, where only the relevant parts of the real environment are modeled. So those parts that are not important are not modeled. And maybe I'll just go a little bit deeper and explain how I come to this definition or why I personally like it. The reason is that when I think about evolution as an optimization, let's say, solution or algorithm, it's also trying to find some solutions for something, but it's trying to find the solutions in real world. So for example, when birds invented how to build nests so they can protect themselves, they didn't invent it within one generation or within one lifespan. Basically, not like we, when we would think like, okay, how to cover our heads when we are sleeping, you know, we will think about it, plan and so on. But birds don't have intelligence. So basically evolution was optimizing this problem for them by giving birth to new kind of birds that had some tendency or some urge to like take piece of, you know, tree or something and put it somewhere, and basically by this almost random evolutionary process somehow it led to, or not somehow, actually there was natural selection pressure which led to birds actually building nests. And the thing is that this took probably thousands or millions of years, because evolution was trying to find this solution in the real world, which is extremely complex, extremely many amount of parameters, and you cannot use many tricks for optimizing the search process as we can do with intelligence, because evolution cannot plan, evolution cannot use abstraction, evolution cannot test different hypotheses and then go back and then use only the hypothesis that's actually the right one or the best one and so on. And now this is the moment where the intelligence comes in. It's almost like same thing like evolution, in my opinion, except you transfer the problem to some simplified representation of the real world, and then you are looking on how to find some patterns, how to use some other tricks, to find some solution or to solve some goal in this simplified environment. And abstraction, when I think about, when I think about attention, like what is actually attention, in my opinion, it's the thing that in this simplified mental model, you want to represent only those part of the environment that are relevant for your goals. So, and this is where attention comes in. It's like if, for example, I feel that there is something, I need to know more information because my mental representation of that part of the world, for example, is not sufficient, or I think that there can be some benefit if I know more about that stuff, I can either look there, you know, and just receive new amount of data and get much more detailed representation about that part, or I can read about it, which is, again, just some kind of patterns, maybe more abstract than just looking somewhere, but the principle is the same. And then there is also this thing that because intelligence is working in a universe that has limited resources, like everything has limited resources, so you also want intelligence to work as optimal as possible, or to be using these scarce and limited resources as optimal as possible. So you also don't want to put attention on things that are absolutely irrelevant to your solution, because basically this mental model that you have in your head has always some limits. It's like you cannot have bigger brain or something like that. And also the time is limited resource and so on. So this is where is the similarity between evolution and intelligence, that you're optimizing something and you're using limited resources that you have around. So when I compare intelligence and evolution, it's basically very similar things, except one is operating on these mental simplified representations, the other is operating on real complex environment, but the goal is kind of the same. It's just you are using different tools to achieve something. And something about this representation or the simplified model. I'm thinking about it like it could be, I don't think it's a memory or pure memory of your previous experiences. I actually think it is your previous experiences together with your current understanding of the world, which is changing all the time. So it's like long-term memory connected with short-term memory, playing basically on the same battlefield, being together, one is helping the other and so on, but I wouldn't really split them. Like, in my opinion, it's not a memory of your or knowledge or something like this. In my opinion, it's just representation of this complex real world environment in your head. So it's like you look on the world around you and basically you try to put as much as possible, of course, only the relevant stuff in your head, run these hypotheses, plan things, you know, like choose different things, decide if you want to put your attention on that thing or that thing, so your representation can get more richer in that area and so on. And the, like, again, the best thing when compared with dump evolution is that you can do this much faster than in evolution. Like, doing these things in evolution would take you a million years, just like with the example with birds. So when I'm thinking about this representation, I think patterns are really important part of the representation, because basically you or some process in the intelligence in the brain is looking on this representation and trying to find patterns in various things. And I can say, like a joke, that the more patterns you know, the more person or the bigger person you are, or the bigger human, because you just have much more choices for your decisions, for learning new stuff, for and so on. So I think patterns are like these little secrets that if you don't know some pattern, like it's there, it's still there in the environment, it does exist, you just don't know, you cannot connect those few things together. But once you connect them together, you know that pattern, you can use it. And like, this is one of the biggest miracles, actually, in my opinion, that finding patterns by yourself, inventing them by being creative, or kind of like copying them or stealing them, that's the way how you can grow this knowledge in your brain and basically make this representation better, use it better, and so on. So it's probably important to define a pattern, what pattern means, and I actually think good definition is that pattern is something that happens in a regular and repeated way, you know. So pattern can be like you have an image and you see pattern on this, but pattern can actually be something that happens in time. So it's some kind of sequence and pattern. These two things are very similar in my opinion. And maybe one more thing about the uncertainty of the environment, of the real world. Like, the world in itself is very uncertain, or like some things don't really happen, or I mean, sometimes we don't know why some things happened and so on. This is one thing. And then the other thing is that sometimes you want to model certain aspects of the environment in this mental representation with some kind of probability, because you either don't know for sure if these things really happened or if it is dead or dead or so on. And you also sometimes want to model it with this probability because you don't want to go in much detail, you know. So it's like, okay, there is some certain probability that I know this is true and so on, and it's okay for me because it's sufficient to achieve my goals, you know, and so on. So I think when I think about this representation, and we are working on different models in our groups, I think about it like it can be some probabilistic graph or some graph of some probabilities, you know, and it can be just growing in certain direction where you want to get more detailed, specialized information, representation about the thing, or it can be really high level and you have just abstract understanding of certain things. And we can model this probabilistic graph probably, like there are these ideas with probabilistic languages or different neural networks or some Bayesian models, you know, and stuff like that. So I don't know which one will be the winning strategy at this moment, but we'll see. But I am quite sure it will be something which is probability hierarchy together, because then you can get abstractions and all these things. And maybe I should also mention this thing that reasoning, basically, which should be running on top of this representation and looking for inference and deduction and induction and all these things. So basically trying to find the correlations in the representation, trying to find new patterns, and also trying to learn why or causalities, you know, like something in your representation was caused by something else. And when you are searching for this, you are making your representation much richer, and therefore you can find there more patterns or more useful patterns. And the ultimate goal of the intelligence is to actually use it for something. So if you have a lot of patterns, a lot of knowledge, and you know what is caused by what and so on, then you can use it for something. And this is the funny thing, this is what evolution cannot do, you know, because evolution cannot do these things. Like, evolution doesn't see the direct correlation between one object and another object. But with abstraction that you have in your intelligence, you can actually see this thing. So in other words, for intelligence actually need to try those things to move forward. We don't need to do this thing.
You were comparing evolution and intelligence. But what do you think? Can evolutionary principles be used in artificial intelligence development?
I think we can, and this is basically what there are many evolutionary algorithms and optimization strategies and stuff like that. And we are kind of using them, like even right now we have some genetic programming thing, but I think that even the evolutionary principles are a dumb version, or are dumb when compared to intelligence. That with intelligence you can do these things, like you can look into the future, you know, and you can choose what you will abstract, what you will not abstract, and so on. And intelligence is doing this. And so let's say, for example, like think about some normal problem that we have here. We have some code for our games, for example, that we want to optimize. And now, will you use evolutionary algorithms to optimize that piece of code, or will you use a person, a programmer, with his intelligence, his experience, knowledge, and all these things to optimize that code? I would use the person, because I know that it will be just faster, because he will think differently than how the evolution would think. So I think that evolutionary principles can be used for some things, but I think that the optimization strategy evolution is it's worse than intelligence.
But to get there, to get to this high performing AI, or at least to human AI, human level AI, can we use some principles of, let's say, human development stages from child to adulthood?
Yes, this is what we call this gradual guided learning. But again, it's just a trick or a speed up for the learning process, because we as humans and our society, we already went through this path. And basically, I could say in a way that our civilization already searched this space of all these possibilities, found a way that's working, and we don't need to repeat this, or we don't need our AI to repeat this search, because it would take, probably even with good computers, it would probably take millions of years or something. So here we can learn from, or AI can learn from what we have already learned, civilization already learned. And so we will have guided gradual learning, and guided means that somebody, mentor or us, or some predefined learning school, will guide the AI through the steps that we know are important to get some knowledge about the world, to basically have really useful representation about the environment and not the unuseful things and so on. And gradual is gradual in a way that we don't just want to throw everything on the AI, even patterns, like highly complex patterns that the AI would not be able to understand. We just actually want, at the beginning, throw simple patterns to the AI, to present it with a simple environment where it can actually find some patterns, you know, in a way that it can grasp and continuously forward. And example is that, for example, when you have a small child, you don't teach it how to program by just throwing programming books and computer on it, on the child, because the child would not know what to do with it and so on. So it will be just overwhelmed by all these, let's say, patterns, you know. But if you first teach it how to speak and, you know, write and read and all these things, and eventually gradually you get to patterns that are representing programming things that can work. And it's actually, in my opinion, much faster, because you build up this pattern recognition hierarchy gradually. And and maybe one more example with this gradual learning is that if you think about, like, you decided I'm going to learn Chinese language, and how to read and write in Chinese. You would probably not start by just opening some Chinese book, you know, and trying to find the patterns in these Chinese, you know, symbols and everything, because that would probably take forever. It's like you would need to encode all these things, and it will be like some hieroglyphs and all these things. But what you can do is you will actually find some book that some like beginner Chinese beginner thing, and you will start with understanding the completed or the absolute basics of Chinese. You will understand those patterns, then you will move on next chapter, you will learn a little bit more complex patterns, you move on chapter 3, a little bit more complex pattern, and this way you can actually get to understand Chinese language and their symbols and all these things. But if you have to just decode all these things, I think that's even for superhuman intelligence really hard job. So to sum this up, basically, like my final definition of intelligence would be something that intelligence works on simplified representation of the world, where it searches for patterns that may help to find some goal or some optimal way how to find a goal. And it's doing on this simplified mental representation because it's cheaper and faster than doing it in a real world environment. And also in intelligence, you can have better structures and you can use different optimization strategies better than evolution to find the solution. So basically, intelligence is using planning, abstraction, looking for correlations in events, how things relate to each other, and so on. And intelligence is optimizing ways how to achieve these goals, and is always looking for more efficient ways how to use limited resources.